Hi everyone. Today we are going to start our second unit. In that, the first topic is special tools and utilities. In this section, we are going to see set of commands. In today's class, we are going to learn about standard streams in Unix and a set of filter commands. Let's start with standard streams in Unix. Usually, when we are executing a command, the input to the command will be receiving from our standard input device, that is your keyboard. And after executing the command, the output will be displayed on the screen, that is your standard output device. And the input and output files are usually, it is a stream of characters. Then, what is standard stream? Standard stream means it is the pre-connected channel between the program and your standard input output devices. In the Unix system, there are three input output stream files. They are standard input, standard output, and standard error stream file. Standard input stream is nothing but this is the stream which is containing the data from the keyboard and going as the input to your program. Then standard output stream is the stream which is containing the output from the program and going to display on your screen. Standard error stream is the stream which is containing the error messages from the program and it will be displayed on the screen. So standard streams are nothing but the stream which is containing data, standard streams are nothing but the pre-connected channels between the program and your standard input output devices. STD in stream file contains the input to the program. STD out stream file is containing output from the program, and STDERR stream file is containing error messages from the program. So here we are taking input from the keyboard and taking output and producing the output on the screen. Suppose we want to read the input from a file and also we want to display the output into a file, not on the screen. For that, we are using that input-output redirection. So what is input-output redirection? The process of redirecting input or output to a file instead of the standard input-output devices are calling as input-output redirection. Standard input device means your keyboard. Standard output device is your monitor or screen. Instead of taking input from the keyboard and instead of displaying output on the screen, we are going to receive the input from the file and send the output to a file. That process is calling as input-output redirection. In that, the first one is the input redirection. Input redirection means we are going to accept the input from a file instead of accepting from the keyboard, that is your standard input device. How can we achieve this? For that, we are using two input redirection symbol, that is less than symbol and pipe symbol. First, let's see the working of less than symbol. I have written one command here, cat less than symbol F1. Here, cat command is using to display the content of the file F1. What is the input to the cat command? Input to the cat command is the file F1, not from the keyboard. So here the input to the cat command is from the content of the file, not from your keyboard. For that we are using less than symbol, and the output of this particular command will be the content of the file F1. Here, the purpose is to display the content of a file. And what is the name of that file? That name of the file, we are not the content of the file we are not reading from the keyboard, we are reading from a file. This is called as the input redirection. Then pipe symbol. Pipe symbol is also using for input redirection. But here on the left side of the, what is the purpose of the pipe symbol? Pipe symbol is using to combine one or more commands. There will be one command on the right side and also there will be one command on the other side. So the input to the right side command will be the output of the left side command. So when we are talking about the input redirection about the second command, the input to the second command or the right side command is the output of the left side command. So here the input is receiving from another command, not from any file, not from your input device, the standard input device keyboard. So these are the two symbols we are using for input redirection. Less than symbol, which allow us to read the input from a file, and pipe symbol allow us to read the input from another command. Next one is output redirection. Output redirection means whatever output has generated, it will be sent to a file or displaying into a file instead of displaying on the screen. Here, the symbols we are using for output redirection are greater than symbol and pipe symbol. Let's see first the working of greater than symbol. On the left side of the greater than symbol, I have cat space F1. So the purpose of this command is to display the content of the file F1. And where should we display this content? The output should be redirected to the another file called F2. For that output redirection, we are using greater than symbol. So whatever content we are going to display, that is the content of F1, has to be displayed into the file F2. Sorry, not on the screen. Then another output redirection symbol is pipe symbol. As I told you, pipe symbol, there will be a left side command and right side command also. The output of the left side command is sending or redirecting to another command, not redirecting to any file or not redirecting to your screen. So here, pipe symbol is also using for output redirection. The process of receiving input from a file is calling as input redirection, and the symbol using for that is less than symbol, and the pipe symbol is using to receive the input from the command. Next one is the output redirection. Output redirection is using to send the output to a file, not to the screen. For that, we are using greater than symbol. Pipe symbol is also using, which allow us to write the output or send the output to another command. Next, we are moving on to the next topic, that is filter commands. What is a filter? Filter is nothing but, it is the program to process a data stream. That means we have set of data, we want to do some manipulations on this data and we have to get the result. For that we are using filter commands. Filter commands are using to receive the data and manipulate that data and show a result. Here I have written 8 important filter commands in the slide. In that, the first 4 filter commands we are going to study in today's class, that is cat, wc, sort, cut. Unique, paste, tr and grep command we'll be discussing in the next class. First one is cat command. The main 4 purposes of the cat command are create a file, display the content of a file, append the content into an existing file, then concatenate the content of 2 files. So first we'll see create a file. So create a file means what? We have to give some content or the input to a file, right? So that content we will be getting from the keyboard and that input will be redirecting to a file, not redirecting to any other, not redirecting to any screen. We are redirecting to a file. Here, this is an example for your output redirection, which means what is the content we are going to type in the file that will be reading from the keyboard and sent to the file using output redirection symbol greater than. So this is the way we are using cat command to create a file. Then the next one, displaying the content of the file. The format is, or the syntax is, simple. Cat command followed by the name of the file will give the content of that particular file. Next, there is a file already existing, but we need to add some more data along with the existing data. For that, we are using two greater than symbols. Cat followed by two greater than symbols followed by file name. Then whatever data you are typing now from the keyboard, it will append at the end of the existing content of the file F1. That is the another purpose of cat command, appending the content into the existing file. Next one is the concatenation. Suppose if we have two files, we want to concatenate the content of two files and redirect that concatenated content into another file, that is F3. For that, we are using the greater than symbol, because we are doing concatenation and the output is redirecting to. So here it is output redirection. That's why we are using greater than symbol. Okay. Then it will be stored in another file F3. Suppose if the file F3 is existing, then the output will be overwriting the existing content if you are using only a single greater than symbol. If we are using two greater than symbol here instead of a single greater than symbol, it won't overwrite the existing content. It will append the concatenated content at the end of the existing content. Understand the difference between single greater than symbol and double greater than symbol. Single greater than symbol will allow us to redirect the output to the next file, but it will overwrite the existing content. Whereas double greater than symbol will allow us to redirect the output to the another file, but it will not override the existing content. Whatever content is there, at the end of that content, it will add the particular output. So these are the four purposes of your cat command. Next one is the WC command. WC means word count. As the name indicate, WC command is using to get the number of words, the number of characters, the number of lines of a particular file. And by default, WC command displays four columns output. Here I have mentioned the command WC followed by the file name, and the output will contain four column output. The first column indicates the number of lines. The second column indicates the number of words. Third column indicates number of characters. And the fourth column indicates the name of the file. Suppose I want to get only the number of lines in the file, or I want to get only the number of words, or I want to get only the number of characters. For that, we have set of options, supporting options. Those are hyphen C, hyphen L, hyphen W. So if you are using WC space hyphen L, it will give only the number of lines in that particular file. If you are using WC space hyphen C, it will give only the number of characters in the file. If you are using WC space hyphen D, it will give only the number of words in that file. So that is about the WC command. By default, it will give four column output, and in order to get only the particular column output, we have the options hyphen C, hyphen L, hyphen W. Next one is sort command. As the name indicate, it is using to sort the content of a file either in ascending or descending order. By default, sort reorders lines in ASCII collating sequence. ASCII collating sequence is nothing but the preference is going like this. First preference is white spaces, then numbers, then uppercase letters, then lowercase letters. Now you can look into the example. Here I have displayed the content of file F1 using cat, and this is the output. The file F1 contains four lines. The first line is starting with the capital letter, then second line starting with the small letter, again starting with the capital letter, then a number. Now we want to sort the content of file F1. How can we give the command? The command sort followed by the name of the file. So it will sort in the ASCII collating sequence. So first preference is numbers. Since we don't have any white space here, first preference will go to numbers. So the first one will be 2020. Then uppercase letters. Again, we have two words, happy and year. Those two words will arrange in the alphabetical order. Then we have the line starting with small letter. So this is the how sort command works. Now we have to know the set of options what we are using along with sort command. The first option is hyphen F. That means when we are sorting, if we want to ignore the case, then we can use the hyphen F. So hyphen F option allow us to ignore the case while sorting. Hyphen N allow us to sort in the numeric order. That means suppose if the file is containing numeric value, we can give N option. So it will sort on numeric order. The next one is the hyphen M. Hyphen M means it is used to merge two or more files. Then hyphen R, it is using to sort in the reverse order. Suppose we have sorted in the ascending order. After that, if we give hyphen R option, it will sort in the reverse order. Then hyphen U is used to display unique values, which means the file what I am going to sort, suppose if the file is containing repeated values or repeated lines, after sorting, it won't give the repetition of the lines. It will represent only once that repeating lines. This is possible with the help of the option hyphen U. Next one is the hyphen K option, which means since our file is containing different fields, we can perform sort on a particular field. That is possible with the help of K. Next one is hyphen O. If you look into this example, after the sorting of a file 1, the output will be displayed on the screen. Okay, but if we want to send the output into another file, we can use the option hyphen O. So if I give sort space hyphen O space F1 space F2, it will allows us to sort the content of F1, and the sorted content will be sent into another file called F2. Look into the example. F1 we have already sorted, and the sorted content is this one now. Again, I want to sort it in the reverse order. Then the output will become output. The expecting output will become new year happy 2020. So for that we are using hyphen R option. I have mentioned only one example here with option hyphen R. So we were discussing about the sort command. It allows us to sort the content of the file either in ascending or descending order. Then we have seen the set of options. Then it is following the ASCII collating sequence also. And today's last command is cut command. Cut command means it allow us to extract the specified characters or columns from the specified file. That means now you can look into this example. In this particular example, I have displayed the content of the file F1, and the content is 001, 002, 003, which means it contains three column values, right? So if we want to extract only the particular column data, we are using cut command. So the cut command is using to extract specified characters or columns from the specified file. Then options which we are using with cut command are hyphen B. It will extract the character based on the byte position. Hyphen C will extract the character based on the character position. Hyphen F will do the extraction based on the field number. That means if we want the third field, based on that we can perform the cut operation. Next one is the hyphen D. That means it is representing delimiter. Delimiter means what? It is used to specify the symbol which we have used to separate the fields in the file. So look into this example. We have the example here. Cut space hyphen D space colon space hyphen S F space 1,3 space F10. Which means extract the first and third character, or extract the first and third column from the file F10, which are separated by the symbol colon that we have mentioned with the option D. So we have to extract the first and third column characters from the file F10, which are separated by colon. Now you can look into this example. We have displayed the content of F1 using cat command. These are the content 001, 002, 003. Now I want to extract only the first column characters. So since we are going to extract the character, we can use the option hyphen C, and we are going to extract the first column. So give the number as 1 and the input file name, that is F1. So it will extract only the first column characters from your file, then the output will be 000. Suppose we want to extract first and third. So you can, again, since we are extracting the character, we can give hyphen C option and followed by the number of columns, that is 1,3, then the input file, it will give the output as 01, 02, 03. Instead of representing the column numbers with a comma, we can give the range also. So cut space hyphen C space 1,2,3 space F1 will allow us to extract the columns 1,2,3 from the file F1 using this command. So the output will be 001, 002, 003. So last command was cut command. It will allow us to extract the characters or columns from the specified file, and we had seen the options and we had seen few examples also. Thank you for watching.